Good evening. First tonight, Britney Spears has hit back at claims she mimed her way through her debut concert in Australia. The 27-year-old was described as extremely upset over reports in the media that her first performance in Perth was lackluster. Her promoter said the singer has received thousands of positive messages from fans. Britney's performing 15 dates of her circus tour across the country. X Factor judge Cheryl Cole is to double up with Snow Patrol as part of a special Children in Need concert at London's Royal Albert Hall. The unlikely duo has already got people talking, with the band's frontman saying there have been a few raised eyebrows. Now staying with the charity concert, and there have been reports that Robbie Williams would perform on stage with Take That. The Sun newspaper said Robbie, who left the band in 1995, was set to duet at the event with Gary, Mark, Howard and Jason. Today, the BBC denied the story, saying the rumours are categorically not true. Sorry about that. Well, now the next band began life in New Jersey, not exactly an epicentre for rock music, you might think, and you might know them from their former name, What About Frank? But the Parlor Mob, as they're now known, have been making waves in the music industry and getting rave reviews from critics around the world. They're playing in London tonight, and a little earlier, Emma Jones went to meet them.
I think we're just honest, contemporary rock and roll. I think we just like good music, and we're influenced by good music. This train is leaving, it's rolling down the track, singing, ain't no turning back. Singing, ain't no turning back.
Fern Cotton on Radio 1 has played your latest tune. Is that a big thing for you?
After being told what a big deal it is, of course we're like so happy with it. And we've gotten like a lot of nice responses about it from people on the internet, and also just like even like some of the other bands that we were touring with recently. Some of the guys that tech for them, like, dude, I just heard you guys on Radio 1. We're like, oh, sweet, it's awesome.
Yeah. Totally.
Did you thank Fern?
Yeah, we thanked her. I thanked her via text message.
Did you get one back?
No.
She's playing hard to get.
What are you gonna do?
What have you seen of the UK so far?
We saw Stonehenge at night, which was cool. Yeah. We barely could see it, but we saw it. That was awesome.
The security guys, they were really nice. They came out with flashlights and pointed their flashlights on the, or their torches, as they called them, out onto Stonehenge so we could see. We were there at like, what was it, like midnight or something?
Yeah.
We were there, and it was pretty cool. Kind of creepy, but still really cool to see it.
I think we're all ready to start working on like new material. When we go back tomorrow, we're gonna start working on our next record over the holidays and stuff like that. And
sounds so funny.
For a while, we'll be working on our next record, so we're looking forward to that.
Emma Jones reports. Now, it's a romantic fantasy starring teenage heartthrob of the moment, Robert Pattinson, as a 17-year-old vampire. On its first day, it grossed $41 million at the US box office, making it an overnight global success. It is, of course, Twilight. Well, now, the new sequel, New Moon, opening next weekend. British fans are being treated to a special one-off Meet the Stars event in London. Now, our entertainment correspondent, Lizo Mazimba, is there for us now. There you go, Lizo. Take it away.
Yes, I'm over at the big party for Twilight New Moon, where we think Robert Pattinson, the star of the movie, has literally just arrived in the past few seconds, as there appears to be quite a bit of screaming behind me. Now, we're hoping to have a few words with him in a second. Twilight, as you say, is an absolute phenomenon. It is one of the biggest films of the year and has a huge audience, and I am joined now by the star, Robert Pattinson. So, Robert, he's come talk to E24 first. What's it like, the reception you're getting here?
What's what like?
The reception you're getting here, Robert.
It's unbelievable. I mean, it was kind of similar last time in London as well, but I'm always surprised by the fan reaction everywhere. It seems to just be explosive. So, yeah, it's a great feeling.
Why do the books and the films, do you think, touch so many teenagers in so many ways?
I don't know, they just touch teenagers. I mean, they seem to, I think people hold up that Edward-Bella relationship as like a kind of ideal or something, and so people are sort of desperate to reach for it. But I really don't know why. I mean, it's obviously just touched people in a very profound way.
And how's it for you, basically becoming one of the biggest actors on the planet over the past 18 months?
Just completely bizarre. I don't even know what else to say about it. It's a kind of an amazing, it's a trip.
Well, they're chanting, "We want Rob," so we'd better let you go. But Robert Pattinson, always a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you very much. Nice to see you again.
That was the star of the movie, Robert Pattinson, who of course plays vampire Edward Cullen, coming of course to talk to E24 before anyone else. And he's going to be now surrounded by screaming fans for the next few hours. They're going to perform on stage and there, answer fans' questions for what is one of the most anticipated movies of 2009.
Good work on the red carpet, Elizo. Thank you very much indeed. Well, that's all the entertainment news for now. I'll be back with more from the world of showbiz at 9:30 here on the BBC News. But now, back to you, Joanna.
Thank you very much. And doesn't Robert Pattinson seem nice?
Yeah, very nice. Yeah, very noisy there
as
well.
Yeah. See if it lasts, though, in that firestorm of publicity. Must be extraordinary. Now, the main headlines. The Queen has led a...